In Lightstream Studio, each element that you add to your scenes is represented as a layer that can be independently repositioned and edited. If you've used photo editing software such as Adobe Photoshop, GIMP, or Paint.net, then you'll be right at home using layers in Lightstream Studio. But if it's your first time working with layers, don't worry, it's easy. Think of layers as an actual stack of items that you look at from the top down. Some items may partially or fully overlap the ones below it. You can move the positioning of each layer individually from others. Layers make it easy to customize your overlays. An example stack of layers can start with a game source layer with your overlay image on top. Now we can add a fun GIF above that and add text layers with your social media information on top of those. You can even add dynamic data-driven graphics through a Rainmaker or third-party integration overlay on top of all of them. If a layer is obstructing important elements of the one below it, just like in the real world, you can swap their positions in the layer pane by dragging a layer to be above or below another. In gamer projects, the game source layer is locked as the bottom layer. On the properties bar that shows up when any visual layer is selected, there are move forward and move back buttons. The move forward button can quickly bring the selected layer up one space in the stack, while the move back button brings the layer down one. Did a layer that you added disappear as you edited your scene? Drag that layer to the top or keep clicking the move forward button until it shows up. If you have a lot of layers, we recommend renaming them to make each easier to find in the layers list. Double-click the layer name or click the pencil icon to rename the layer to something easier to find. To learn more about making the best of Lightstream Studio, watch our other YouTube videos or visit the knowledge base at golightstream.com.